Right.
I need to. It's health and safety.
I think these are poison,
issues.
So we'll have to have these for you.
No.
Just in case.
Shit, where are the glasses?
Oh, yeah.
It might be poison, mate.
Actually, hang on. Justin, aren't they your M&Ms?
They are, actually, yeah.
Yeah.
But I could give you the money for them, except I'll give you half the money now. Hello.
Hello.
Everyone, welcome to our E3 reactions video. We'll discuss. As and when. We're watching the Sony one first. Yeah. Myself, this is Matt. You haven't seen him before.
Hello, world.
All five of you.
Shut up.
So yeah, we'll crack on. We'll start with the Sony press conference and we'll go from there.
Go on. Right. What we're seeing right now is a lot of shouting and explosions.
That was Arkham Knight.
Is that
Arkham Knight?
It's out, like, in a week.
Oh, yeah, we're going to
do a video
of that. Yeah. Oh, yeah. It's basically us watching
an hour
and a half porn.
Jurassic Park! Lego Jurassic... Oh, gutted, mate.
Oh, shit.
Both fell off.
So we saw a T-Rex with his jaw fell off. That was the highlight of the intro. Here comes Sean Layden.
Has only just started.
Oh, here he is.
The world famous Sean Layden.
Thanks for coming tonight. Welcome to thousands of theatres across North America.
He dyes his hair.
He's wearing, Sean Layden is wearing a wig.
He's got like a Count Dooku thing going on, but backwards.
No. I'm wondering where the rest of this next
one. Into the folds.
We have seen so much creativity from developers and so much innovation from engineers. Who continue to evolve yet our most powerful.
Okay,
console.
This is the boring part where they go blah 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 blah.
Some familiar and some entirely new are taking advantage of PS4's powerful technology to create indeed the best place to play.
Right, so we're championing PS4 at the moment.
Well, the meat is dead. So, yeah.
Of engineers, creators, and developers.
Did it ever really?
PS4 became the start of a new reality.
The launch games were good, and they just never made any.
A reality where games and gamers come first. A reality where games and developers matter. A reality where games drive innovation.
Right, I know you two haven't seen the Microsoft one, but they're basically saying the same thing. There's just a blue background. That's what's going on.
Have you seen the Microsoft?
Oh, well, you're
indeed, it. A reality where games are the cultural zeitgeist.
Funny me watching your reactions.
Yeah.
This new reality of gaming is expansive,
I've heard that Sony
inclusive,
have won
and boundless.
Have won?
Yeah.
Did they have a fight? Did Sean Layden throw it out with Bill?
Our closely connected network has continued to grow. And represents more
you
than
Peter Molyneux is in Microsoft's, they've lost.
We have risen to the new challenges and opportunities of becoming
you always lose
the ready
forum.
Acorn and
Milo.
Milo.
What continues to excite me every day
go,
are the I believe we're witnessing an historic evolution in gaming, full stop.
Oh, wow.
One that is not only redefining how we play, but it's broadening
love
the appeal of PlayStation.
When they're talking about,
to
like, we're going
to
bring a new definition together.
Don't they say the same thing
every year?
Yeah.
And then they're like, here's FIFA, here's Call of Duty, here's Assassin's Creed.
Yeah.
There you go.
I didn't hear that. Where the movie
is. It is conceived as a poetic story
Ooh.
Of adventure.
Oh, I know what this is. Keep it going.
Heroism and companionship. Personally proud and incredibly proud to introduce this
Pokemon.
What have we got?
What have we got now? Only on PS.
Can we cut? There we are.
Ooh.
It better be Little Big Planet.
Oh,
I
Little Big Planet.
I forgot. I meant to say that in the predictions, but
I love Little Big Planet.
I thought.
Oh, no.
It really disappoints me. It is only on PlayStation.
I know what this is. This is literally going to break Japan.
Last Guardian. Is what I'm thinking because it's a bird.
it's a
freaking book.
It's
angel,
a thing with Japan Studio. Yeah.
Yeah. This is
yeah.
Pretty.
Yeah.
So. Yeah. This is. It's got to be. This is the game that's like 9 years in the making.
I was gonna say it's been
what?
Yeah. They announced this years and years and years and
after
years.
Shadow
yeah,
of the Colossus.
Yeah. This is Last Guardian.
Is it a
what
sequel?
Sort of
genre?
Shadow of the Colossus.
Shadow of the Colossus and Ico, which were two games on the PS2.
That's how long.
I really want to cut that grass.
So, yeah.
This isn't Zelda. Can't do that.
I also called Last Guardian.
Oh yeah, because Abby's over there, by the way.
I also called that it was Last Guardian.
Right, so yeah,
it was kind of spoken.
So we've got the Last Guardian trailer at the moment. And he's screaming in Tibetan.
Yeah, I don't know.
Whoa!
That's
one.
A chihuahua.
A chihuahua bird.
Bubbeak. I think they look more like a hyena.
Really, Bubbeak? So a hippogriff.
Bubbeak's been sentenced to death and then cut his head off and stuck a chihuahua's head on him.
So, Karrot, you've played Icon Shadow Classes, haven't you?
Yeah, not very much of them though.
Okay.
Because I'm not very good at them.
You know they're sad games, right?
Yes, I've seen a playthrough of Shadow of the Colossus to the end. It is like a weird twist ending. It's a really good ending though.
There's two ways this game's going to end, isn't it?
Yes.
I'll let you decide, viewers, whether I'm right, but I think you'll know what I'm talking about if you watch Shadow of the Colossus. Oh, blimey.
IGN reported, look at him.
What
was it, 6 months ago that this had been cancelled and Sony kicked off and said, no, don't say it, don't tell everyone this is cancelled.
Quiet. Well, it actually looks pretty stunning, actually, graphically and animation. The monster looks wicked. Whatever the head
it
is.
I'm thinking, though, the character itself looks a bit more cartoon.
That's the kind of style that they do
Shadow of the Colossus and Ico in.
Yeah.
I guess I'd rather them do that than attempt to do graphics of a human and it always turning out wrong.
Okay.
Ended up looking like ODST faces.
Yeah.
Horrible.
So, he's gonna jump, I'm sure.
He's gonna be caught by his giant chihuahua.
His giant, is that what it is?
Chihuahua chicken.
A chihuahua chicken. A chihuahua. Edit out.
Oh my god, Matrix! Oh man. No. Oh,
my hand!
That's what I thought. I thought he got his arm.
Whoa! Boy?
The feathers look a bit dodgy.
Yeah.
That might be the resolution we're watching this in. Yeah. I reckon in game that would look better.
To be honest, this looks pretty cool, actually.
I can imagine we're seeing this in HD would be even just be
cool. Yeah.
If this gets released, it will be a very, very weird game. It should be released.
Eventually.
They wouldn't.
9 years from now.
They wouldn't do a whole thing on it as their opening game at E3.
Yeah.
I've got a feeling that kid shouting that all the time is going to get annoying. Or having to shout that all the time.
Yeah, actually, yeah. So a little kid's quite annoying. But that's just life, isn't it?
Yeah.
So we'll get over that, I'm sure. So it's quite environmental puzzles.
Oh, right. See, I haven't played Shadow of the Colossus, so I don't know what to expect from this.
Shadow of the Colossus is...
this does look very good.
Yeah.
It's one of those games that keeps you constantly in awe. Yeah. There's no, traditional enemies. The first enemy in the game is like a huge rock golem thing, and all the enemies are like that. You've got to climb on their backs and things. And
sort of almost
them.
Got Japanese Tomb Raider feel about it.
Yeah.
It's sort of that attitude. I get what you mean.
This is like Tomb Raider.
Video game logic. Lara Croft goes into a tomb, hasn't been opened in thousands of years. All the candles are there.
Yeah.
Finds a machine gun upgrade.
Yeah. That's very cool.
Whoa, right there.
Nearly I like that. That's pretty cool. Oh god. Oh, well, that's not good. So,
who's playing this game? Run properly.
Yeah, it's annoying that they keep stopping.
He's trying to get his homies open now. So, actually, this looks pretty cool.
It's a small thing, but I really like that it kicked the bucket.
Yeah.
And it rolled around and made the noise, yeah. Oh, no, no.
Oh, no. Oh, hell no.
Oh, hello. So, what I'm getting from that is it going to be scripted, or is it all going to be dynamic? Can you mess, a big jump like that up and not grab the tail?
I hope it's not scripted.
Because that could lead to all kinds of hilarious...
That looks scripted.
That is one of my favourite things in Lara Croft, is doing the multiple ways she can die, just to see the reactions.
Death montages.
Did you ever drown her in the swimming pool? That was traumatic.
Oh, yeah.
That was horrific.
I did that at a friend's house once, she freaked out.
She's she's just gone on a week-long bender and found her in the swimming pool.
It's different every time she drowns in each game.
So this is a bit of Shadow of the Colossus coming into it now.
Yeah, this is what Shadow of the Colossus looks like, except this would be an enemy in Shadow in that game.
Don't kill the big man in the demo.
Oh, Oh, the Chihuahua can't die. What? What are you doing?
What is he doing, man?
Oh no!
Let's what are you doing, Alan?
Yeah,
it's got wings.
All right, I thought it was going to.
It's
got
little wings, really the pathetic wings. The wings aren't wings. Fully developed. No. Yeah, that's
it's only little. It's a little gremlin thing.
They just go in a circle to go where they ended up then.
Yeah, I am getting Gizmo vibes.
Gizmo.
Don't feed it after midnight.
Yeah, don't feed it. Turns into a colossus. Maybe it is. Maybe it's a baby colossus.
I don't know, but I want one.
It is pretty cool, yeah. Isn't it? Whatever the head it is.
It looks good.
That looks very good.
Looks like yeah, it could be a very slow-paced game, though.
Slow burner, yeah. I don't think it'll be one of those multiplayer. I don't think it'll whop out a machine gun and start shooting people.
No, okay. Thank
you. Oh, we got Shuhei. Shuhei.
Shida. I could not be happier standing here today. You don't know how long I have waited for this moment.
9 years.
About 9 years.
The international Afghanian who is first ever seen gameplay footage on PlayStation 4. Yes.
You're supposed to be on the PS3, but
and of course I'd like to acknowledge the visionary behind this title for all his creativity, leadership and hard work. The creative director
of the Japanese want to do these conferences because they're so sincere. They actually love what they do.
Yeah.
Oh, I love Sakurai when he does them. Smash Brothers.
Oh, yeah.
He loves it.
He loves a bit of Smash Brothers.
I'd love to go into game design. I was going to take a course in Finland.
Finland?
Yeah.
Wow.
It's a placement.
Yeah.
Thank you. I'm next to introduce a completely new franchise that I'm totally excited about.
Ooh.
New franchise.
It is my pleasure to welcome from Guerrilla Games, Herman Hurst.
It's gotten really
they
hip.
Make the Killzone games, don't they?
Yeah, Guerrilla Games, yeah. It's gotten very hip, hasn't it, E3?
Yeah.
Very slick.
Once every decade or so,
it's Herman.
Studios get a rare opportunity.
Herman
the German. Opportunity to leave behind the comfortable and familiar, to conquer the challenge of exploring exotic new horizons. It's been a long journey getting here, but today, on behalf of everyone at Guerrilla Games, I am delighted to finally unveil our newest franchise.
FPS. I bet you an M&M it's an FPS.
No, I'm not taking that bet. It probably is.
It's very rare that it's actually in-game content.
Yeah.
Why is that after?
Is this a trailer?
Actually, no. Probably,
this doesn't look like game footage in this one.
Oh, no. It
says directly from a PlayStation 4.
It could be a cutscene.
Yeah.
We know we weren't the first ones here.
Ooh. Might not be an FPS. So we're getting cave our paintings.
Speak
cave paintings,
of
the game.
The ones that came before.
Ooh.
The old ones.
You know how you said the other one looked like Tomb Raider?
Yeah.
We should be seeing some Tomb Raider this year.
The old ones.
I'm expecting
that. Rise of the Tomb Raider. The Tomb Raider Rise.
I still need to play that.
Hold on.
That reached the stars.
Oh, hang on a minute.
Is it Doctor Who again?
It's a new franchise, man.
I think this seems like a post-apocalyptic sort of game.
Another one?
It's up against Fallout 4.
If it ain't zombies.
About that, as long as it ain't zombies. Harvest Moon.
Harvest Moon. It looks like The Last of Us.
Yeah.
It ain't, but it looks like
reminds me of sort of I Am Legend.
Yeah.
That's what I couldn't remember the name of it. That's what I was about to say. This looks like
it looks very pretty.
Could
it?
This be an MMO?
Maybe.
Oh.
Well.
Oh. Buffering.
Well,
buffering.
There we go.
This. The environments on this look absolutely incredible. So.
Over time, one by one, the tribes came to these lands. Some. small and humble.
This looks like an American.
They reckon this is what powerful. Zelda's going to sort of be like, just be fast open world.
Yeah. Oh, I know what this might be. I think I saw something earlier.
First to hunt. The first to raise
that is pretty stunning, to be honest.
The weaponry looks good.
Yeah.
Come on.
What brings the Boston?
A machine.
Come on, Earth.
Whatever this is looks
pretty bitchy.
What the fuck?
And look at them!
Who sat on the giraffe's head? They're like they're picking things out of time for in this.
Well, check out, this
you
is
know
gameplay.
When there's a really big gust of wind when it's a frozen day? Like, yeah. You just get all the icicles come off the back of things.
Yeah.
Wow. I have to admit, this looks stunning.
Yeah.
Gameplay.
That looks very Assassin's Creed, that.
And the bushes. Only the leaves are in HD, man.
Oh. Where's Steph go?
So, just copying my
phone. So yeah, it does look very Assassin's Creed.
Wicked.
But it looks good.
It's a bit like, you know, that, like a futuristic, that, you know, that recently that arc. Survival.
Yeah.
The dinosaur tribe game. This looks like a very futuristic one of those.
I'm loving the enemy design there.
Yeah. I swear, this must be like Ark 2 or something.
Can't be, it's a new franchise, apparently, but it's borrowing a lot from other games though. I think that
these days you have to, right?
These days, yeah, you have to make mashups of Creed or Metal Gear.
Metal Gear's supposed to be like this as well. Just an open environment.
Bushes are your best friends. Oh my god. Right. He's a big boy. Jurassic World. With robotic dinosaurs. You ever played the Monster Hunter games?
Again, I do like seeing a main female character.
Did the Monster Hunter levels in Peace Walker count?
Yeah.
That's funny, you were saying that yesterday, weren't you?
Yeah.
I imagine you can probably pick between male and female.
I don't understand why most games nowadays you can't do that.
Because men are more marketable, sadly. I know.
This looks good.
It does look good. That's cool, but the bits fall off the enemy. Whoa, hello! That was the thing that was on the enemy, wasn't it?
This isn't what I thought it might be, by the way. But this does look exactly like Ark Survival in the future.
Ow! Oh, you feel the impact, man. The hits. This looks pretty stunning.
I like that you can tell it.
Yeah.
All in place. And it's dynamically reacting to it as well.
Yeah, it's not just going into an animation.
Whoa!
It's away!
So they've gotten out of the whole gore thing by making the enemies robots.
Yeah.
So they won't have to put Chevy's blood in it.
The stories don't tell where the old ones went. They don't tell us why the machines rule these lands. But they warn us that this balance cannot last.
So that's for one. So you can have an M&M carrot. Horizon.
That looks incredible.
Good. I like the environment.
Yeah.
Oh,
I genuinely thought that was the TARDIS
noise. That was pretty cool. Enjoyed that.
That looks sick.
Yeah. Dumbledore clap for that game.
That was Horizon Zero Dawn.
Looks very good.
Sweary!
And now we've got some Phoenix.
Hang on, these guys got their own conference.
Yeah.
Piss off back to your own stage.
What did we say that? I expected.
Kingdom Hearts 3.
Ooh.
Is this?
Squeenix.
I forgot that's what people.
So they've launched straight into a Square Enix trailer.
Yeah.
Who's here with you?
Go away, we're recording. It's me, Karrot, Matt, Abbie.
Is this?
I don't know.
It's not new Hitman, is it?
Well, the Hitman not too long ago. Oh no, it's supposed to have been a while.
No one's bald yet.
Well, no one's bald yet. We've got a battle.
Can't be hit.
You don't know the hit is. Yeah. Oh no, wait,
I think you're right, Abbie.
Oh,
yeah. He's called it. Yeah. Either that or Slendy's getting a bit.
He's good.
Well done.
It's the red tie, isn't it? That gives it away.
Yeah. It's like catchphrase.
It's been a while since
a
Hitman's come out.
Hitman games are good as well.
Yeah. They're like puzzle games, aren't they, really?
Oh, did the gangster shot.
Yeah. And he caught the bullet. Oh, that's cool. It didn't really tell us much about the game.
Like a logo of like a clothes.
Yeah.
It didn't really tell us much about the game though.
All they make is black suits with red ties.
Yeah. Is that all you got from that trailer? Ooh.
That looks good.
Didn't really show anything.
It didn't. Yeah, it was a good trailer.
It was more a trailer.
Let's have a look.
It's more a movie trailer than being a trailer.
I really wanted from E3 is not to see what's coming next year, what's this year?
This is the world of assassination and brutal. Oh, here we go. Was the world premiere of the new Hitman. Gamers will travel to exotic locations around the world to take out high profile targets. Okay, really? 47 returns in the most ambitious Hitman ever created. Developer IO Interactive are bringing this blockbuster franchise to console and PC, leading with a digital release that will invite gamers to a live and ever-expanding world.
I like
the discs. To grow, deepen, and evolve as time.
Get with the program, old man.
I'm sick of having to install games.
Yeah, I think that's here to stay.
Pain in the ass.
A console exclusive beta.
Oh, you're always worrying about losing the game. PlayStation 4 gamers when they pre-order the game,
which is awesome.
If you don't have the internet, you can't do shit on it.
Contracts. They'll be exclusive to PlayStation 4 players as the year goes on when the game launches. Can't wait for this game. It's great to see Agent 47 back again. Okay, so this next cycle is fantastic. It's a console exclusive and it's fan favorite Street Fighter V.
Bit of Street Fighter.
I suppose it is
a while ago. You know, in the opening trailer for Sony,
I saw it then.
Yeah. This looks awesome.
That might be why Ryu has been added to Super Smash Bros.
To pump up the profile a bit more. So there are new fighters as well. Oh, hello. So we've got a big man called Birdie with a chain.
He looks a bit like Bloodlines.
Cammy.
Yeah, you're right, Abbie.
Cammy's not new.
She was Kylie Minogue.
We don't speak of that movie.
What's wrong with that movie?
What's right with it, first?
I enjoyed seeing Kylie Minogue in a leotard. Okay, I don't know about you. But we know that when that gets released, they're going to have Super Street Fighter V. Super Street Fighter V.
Super Turbo Ultra Alpha Street Fighter V. Arcade Edition.
Arcade fighters just don't excite me.
No, they don't. I like the old school ones.
Tekken 2.
Tekken 2 is good.
I've got Street Fighter 2 HD and Street Fighter 4. Alright, I'm not into them kind of fighters.
Oh, I do love Street Fighter.
This next title. It's the same thing.
Street Fighter 2 Turbo.
Oh, what's this one?
When it's first announced, and expands our very notion of the word scale. To help us tell more about it,
I'd like to welcome
from Hello Games, Sean Murray.
Oh, I'd love it if it was.
From what games?
Like Crash Bandicoot.
Oh, is this like
No Man's Sky?
No Man's, yeah.
So last year,
this looks very impressive.
We showed you a video of this crazy game we're making called No Man's Sky.
Yeah, that's the one. Yeah.
This year, I guess I really just wanted to show you how it plays.
It looks incredible, this game.
That looked like a helicopter from Star Wars, though, actually.
Yeah. You just go to any planet you want.
This is a giant sandbox.
It's basically every planet you go to is randomly generated. So you'll never get the same set of planets as any other planet.
It's like Eve, but it's not point and click.
Not boring.
Yeah, that's the thing. Eve looked incredible, but it's point and click, and you could do nothing but to click on things.
No, you can.
Pink.
Yeah, it's a bit neat.
The colours are all a bit... They all change as you go around
through the world.
Yeah.
This is almost like an indie game, though, this one.
And I do like a good space sim.
Yeah. You don't get them very often, do you?
No, not anymore.
Eve's the only other one, though. I couldn't think of,
to be honest. That's a tiny glimpse of space combat.
Here's the map.
But I've only got three beds, and there's loads that I want to show you. Like this. So this is the solar system that we're currently at. That's where that battle is taking place. But battles like that are taking place across the universe.
But so it's one big seamless world then? Wow.
Whoa.
You can see the other stars nearby that I can reach with my current hyperdrive. And I'm going to pull back a little bit more to give you a sense of the size of the game. When I do, I really need you to keep in mind to understand that every one of these points of light is a sun. And every one of those suns has its own solar system.
Wow, that's pretty impressive,
isn't it? Planet-sized planets orbiting around it. Those have life, ecology.
Oh my goodness.
Shit, yeah, no.
And I can even go a little faster.
Karrot, what are you going to do to get all the achievements
on
that?
I'm never going to 100% this fucking game. Look at this bullshit.
Good and grief.
Places,
I need a PS4.
Yeah, get a PS4, man. You're doing life then, yes. I know, I'm probably going to get one.
We're still fucking this.
Pulling back here.
Over there, in the distance, is the center of the galaxy. That's where we're all trying to get to. And I'm going to do something really stupid. I'm just going to pick one of these at random. And we can go there.
Wow.
Now this was okay in rehearsal, otherwise I wouldn't be here, but if anything horrible goes wrong, just keep in mind.
By our silence, you can tell we're impressed. We don't do this very often. Woo! Wow.
Cool.
So the colours all change depending on what solar system you're in.
So here we are in an undiscovered.
They have
solar
to do that,
system.
I suppose, because the graphics are going to get repetitive.
I can do a scan.
Yeah.
So those land masses, you can go on.
And when I do, you'll see some points of interest. That red one down there is a beacon.
This is probably the most impressive thing, to go from seeing this different space to planet.
And if this game can do it, I don't want to hear any excuses from EA about Battlefront not being able to do it.
Star Wars, yeah.
Because that was the next thing everyone was asking for in Battlefront.
Oh, cool, it's got, every planet's got its 53% oxygen.
Yeah, different levels. Ridiculous, isn't it?
This is insane.
You pop out!
I was like mildly curious of this game last year, but now I'm quite interested.
And this is the planet that we've just found. This is an alien world that we've found together.
It's only a small company that's making it as well.
Yeah.
And it's not like the prettiest planet I've seen better, but I've also seen a lot worse. So I could do a scan. And as luck would have it, there's no alien life. But I can show you this. So every planet in every solar system is fully destructible.
It's a bit of Minecraft style, then.
Yeah.
Right. Sorry about that.
Finish up.
Batteries run out. But
don't lie, you pooed yourself because we were so excited about Batman's Sky. So we had to change his shorts.
Taking a hit from Matt's embarrassment there.
embarrassed himself on camera.
Okay, so
we're still on No Man's Sky. Yeah.
And there's fish.
Good grief, he's in water.
What?
Woo! I suppose he's alright now, he's got up.
There's always a bigger fish.
And I can upload those discoveries.
Don't you dare start quoting that.
Amazing movie, shut up.
That's a whole other video.
I want to know what the point is, like what is the goal? I
think he said everyone was trying to get to the centre point.
Yeah, but why?
Who knows? I'm sold.
I'm sold on.
I'm hoping this is kind of an MMO game.
The concept.
I think
now,
it's
an MMO. When the game is out, and we'll announce a release date soon, I promise. When the game is out, one of you might one day come across this planet. That's just a little glimpse of No Man's Sky. It's got training, fighting, exploring.
I don't know, if one player does something on that planet, will that be there for another player?
For another player?
I imagine they have different servers.
Or can you leave a message for another player?
Yeah, if you destroy something on a planet, can you destroy that planet?
Or they're going to be instanced.
Yeah.
With great scale comes great questions.
That's true.
Yes.
Great. Anecdotes by Abbie there.
With great uncles from great life lessons.
Every time I see that game, it blows my mind. So, moving from the massive scale of the universe to the wonderful complexity and richness of the human imagination.
See, is that PS4 exclusive? Okay,
thanks, Abbie. Sorry, I've got some jelly babies. Thanks, Abbie.
Take a handful.
I'm such a pig.
Who's this? Did that say only on PlayStation?
Yeah, I took three.
That's not a handful.
It's enough.
Got it.
System.
I know there's one thing that I know that I think I saw earlier.
I know one thing coming out on PlayStation.
Hello, thank you very much. I'm proud and excited to be here today to tell you what we've been working on in Media Molecule. It's the most
Does he look like the lecturer at Tom?
It's sort of crazy, and I'm hoping today that I can make you all scratch your heads.
I like making my own shit like games.
When we were making Little Big Planet and Tearaway, we learned a lot about digital creativity. So today I want to tell you about the next
incredible Little Big Planet level character called Trotch World.
Already invested.
The best bit is the co-op in Little Big Planet.
The second one's just good.
It feels surreal and wonderful.
A chimp.
You get paint guns and everything.
I've got the paint gun version of the first one.
It's just game, everyone.
Where you go to play and explore the dreams of others, and then you can create and share your own. Every individual dream is seamlessly linked to the others. It's sort of woven into an open dreamiverse. Exploring journeys through the imaginations of thousands of PS4 gamers. And the thing that unites them all is that feeling of being in a dream.
Are you going to read or not?
But when we tried to capture those dreamlike moments, we found that
look
there
at
were
him.
Suitable tools.
He obviously knows how to read minds.
But they don't want to read multiple men's minds all at one go. Let's be honest, where's that going to be?
I think that's incredibly
easy. It's all going to be one fucking channel.
We focus on the collaboration, the immediacy, and making it feel like a game. So let me show you how it works.
I don't really get
this. It's as simple as moving your controller to create your mark on the world.
Whoa.
This, everything you see here today is on PlayStation 4 with no pre-made assets. The game looks like a moving painting.
Whoa!
Beautiful and moves around
with your imagination. Yeah, we can have some fun with this.
On your sofa, live online, or build on the work of others. You call up their dreams and then remix, collage, and link them together. You stand on their shoulders. Because in 2015, after all, everything is a remix. And creating is easier and more fun when you're in a dream.
We could have so much fun with this. I don't want to ask what you're thinking. No, I am.
What's the point in this?
We found that the more enjoyable we make the creation side, the more varied...
It's just for the sake of doing it.
...surprising are the play experiences.
You can make your own things.
It's one of those things, though. Anything, unless you're really good at it, anything you're going to do is not going to look crap.
I was going to say, I mean, that looks good, but...
There's a professional designer
for it.
It's funny though.
So I've only had a few minutes today, so rather than trying to explain it all, I'm going to give you a taste. I hope it fills your head with questions, and that's natural. Every person we've shown this to over the last 4 years says it takes time to sink in. So we'll have much more to share at Paris Games Week.
What's it called?
Please stay tuned, and in the meantime, I hope you enjoy some of the first dreams realised 100% on PlayStation 4.
Bless you, DIckie.
Oh, thank you. I don't know what to make of this.
I'm not sure what the game is. It's like No Man's Sky. It looks incredibly impressive, but when it's still looking for the meat, aren't we? The bread looks alright, but what's the filling?
Yeah. It's all very well telling me I can do something, but why am I doing it?
Yeah.
unless it's just supposed to be like
a creator. That's creative, a big prize like yeah, that, isn't it?
Or like the Sketchpad studio on Wii U, it's just a way you can mess about.
Running area behind
like a mini movie maker or something.
Hagrid looks a bit different.
That looks absolutely nothing like when they were showing the gameplay a second ago.
No, so is this... When they say it's not, none of it's pre-rendered, so to speak. This surely has to be.
Yeah.
So
you can say this is game footage game? And still show you a cutscene.
Yeah. I think Microsoft tried something similar with Project Spark, that you can make your own game.
Yeah,
no,
yeah.
He's got a
I downloaded the trial to that, I can't work that fucking game out.
I know I had Conker in it, and I was like, ooh, but it didn't.
Oh, that was such a troll when they put Conker in that trailer.
Yeah.
I get the sense it's a sort of a creator that you can then play your own world, but then I don't...
Dreams. Is that what it's called? Dreams?
Yeah.
Creative. A creative game called yeah. Dreams.
What's this? Oh, Media Molecule, yeah.
I'm not convinced by that one, personally.
I'd like to see a bit more about it.
Thank you to the geniuses at Media Molecule. Amazing. Now you can literally create anything you can dream of. A game, a play, music, a performance, all from scratch. Absolutely amazing.
I think it's the same principle as Little Big Planet, but it's not just levels for a game you can make. You can do other things.
Your only lifeline is a woman's voice.
I think it's just a game creator that the user can...
Created by the brilliant storytellers of Campo Santo. Firewatch will be making its console debut on PlayStation. Let's take a look.
Jay, Firewatch. Wouldn't want
to
wear that.
What's in this cave down here?
Manifest tells people not to go too far in there. It's pretty dangerous. You're in it, aren't you?
It doesn't seem that big. Whoa! Oh, no!
We need a good horror after Silent Hill's got cancelled.
After the disappointment of Silent Hill,
that's
yeah.
That's how I knocked out the phone line I used to talk to the service.
Oh man, you're in that mourning for a week.
Oh,
when
I'm so good that game's cancelled. Yeah. You think you'll take to it?
Oh,
being
this isn't a horror.
The isolation gets to me.
This looks like...
I don't talk to the other lookouts as much as I talk to you.
A more in-depth Borderlands, almost.
I like the graphic style. The Team Fortress style, isn't it?
Team Fortress is a good way to put it.
You're probably the last person to have seen them.
Hey, somebody cut the comms.
What?
I'm out here and the wire is cut clean through.
Wait, you're already there? You're not in your tower?
No, I'm not.
Then who is?
Please welcome Adam
Boyd.
I thought more of a
Slender
Man
thing. Well, might develop into a
Hello,
game.
This shit just never gets old.
It's Adam
Boyd. So last year on this very stage, our partners at Activision and Bungie shared incredible vision for Destiny.
Destiny.
Trolled. It wasn't very good, was it?
It was a bit.
It's a bit boring. It's a bit black.
I feel like it's boring. We had in mind for PlayStation from the get-go. One that would help define the next generation of games. And Destiny launched last September and quickly became the biggest launch of a new video game franchise ever.
Was it really just last September? Yeah.
And as a huge fan of the game, and a level 34 Warlock as of 8 days ago.
I'm
very excited to be here tonight to introduce the next great adventure in Destiny.
Destiny 2!
Red Dwarf, what was that?
Yeah.
I'd love there to be a Red Dwarf game.
That'd be
funny. It'd be funny and lighthearted, wouldn't it?
Point and click adventure game. So is this an expansion or a game?
Game.
So if it's just another pre-rendered trailer. Yep, it's another pre-rendered trailer.
Yeah. Well, no, I didn't play Destiny because I heard it was boring.
They weren't that great.
But weren't the graphics in it like incredible?
Yeah, they were. Yeah. Graphics were stunning. The graphics were very good. There wasn't a whole lot to see with
the character.
There's so much moving. It should really get a chance to see
Halo as well.
Yeah.
Bungie.
Oh, yeah.
This already looks better than Destiny.
It's the expansion for Destiny, though. By the looks of it.
I think it's an expansion,
really. No, this looks like an expansion.
It does seem a bit soon for a sequel.
Why would you go to E3 with an expansion?
Because it makes money, essentially.
It is Bungie, they might be
putting an ODST
probably. Yeah, that's true.
See, there's nothing here that's telling me that it's any different.
No?
So if you didn't like Destiny, you wouldn't probably like this.
No, right.
Yeah, that's some of the demonic design.
Yeah. You gotta give it to Bungie though, their skybox is incredible.
Yeah.
Oh, it's Illidan.
2008. way back.
What's the name of it?
The Taken King.
Oh, he said the Taken Ring.
The Taken Ring.
Oh no!
To rule them all.
Now you can trust me, I've tried the new supers and they are delicious! So the first year of Destiny was incredible.
That was a bit awkward.
And the first year played hundreds of hours. Whether you're a huge fan of Destiny, like
see, I'm not a big fan of that because they're going to charge for it.
He's so proud of himself right now.
And of course, there's always going to be more Destiny on PlayStation. We've got new gear, a multiplayer map, a badass co-op strike, and
see,
all new
with Destiny, that's going to cost 20 quid.
On day one
yeah.
And you've already paid 20 quid for the other two expansions, so in total, Destiny would have cost you about 90.
Which is bollocks to pay that
you
much
know
for
it. I know the same guy is missing his too. I know.
Just for a map and some extra guns.
So this year's Assassin's Creed...
Oh, yeah. So this is it's like the awkward uncle.
Oh, to be fair, this one's already been announced.
When
though,
you announce it as this year's Assassin's Creed,
I think this one had already been announced. To be fair, Syndicate.
Yeah, I've heard my name before.
Cool, blimey, Gavner. Comedy English accent.
And I know my twin sister Evie will be by my side.
Where's the dog bit on the hood?
A lot of it. And while I've chosen to front up to these challenges head on, it's my sister who's mastered more of an elegant way. She can be very persuasive. But all you need to know is don't mess with Evie.
Faces still don't look right. The rest look really good. It's still faces are just on.
Environments look amazing. Creepy.
It looks like they're trying to do a bit of a Jennifer Lawrence look here.
Yeah. See, again, this doesn't look any different.
The only thing that interests me this time is it's London. That's it.
In the environment. Yeah.
The thing that interests me that is that it's a theme.
Well, we've had.
They have had females to be fair in the past.
Evelyn.
Evelyn, from Liberation.
Yeah. There was a principal sort of female character in Unity as well, but no one played that. So.
Yeah.
Is this a pre-rendered?
This is pre-rendered. This is.
It's got a little pre. Yeah.
I was gonna say it can't.
Just be sad. I've seen Assassin's Creed. I've played about what 6 of them.
Yeah.
It seems
only
a bit ridiculous
six?
How many there are.
Only 6. Yeah.
I'm pleased to announce that you'll be able to play some very special missions known as the Dreadful Crimes.
Exclusively
on PS4. Now you can select Ichigo or Evie to solve a series of murders but inspired by the works of the most famous detective novelist of Victorian England.
No.
Yeah, now, Final Fantasy has a long history on PlayStation. We're excited to show you a world premiere of the newest addition to the franchise. Let's take a look.
That's what franchise?
Assassin's Creed. No, I was going to say, not, surely not Assassin's Creed again.
Assassin's Creed Syndicate 2. Oh, blimey.
What?
Final Fantasy.
Kingdom Hearts, though. Kingdom Hearts, it's like.
Well, that's how Final Fantasy VII used to look on PS1, where they had the little chibi characters, and then you talk to, like, go into battle, and then you were like, more than one.
Is it a Pokemon? What on earth?
It's a Final Fantasy game because I've already seen mages.
Yeah, the little black mages.
Yeah. That's Cloud.
Looks like it could be Kingdom Hearts.
It does look a bit Kingdom Hearts.
World of Final Fantasy.
Jumping on the Jurassic bandwagon.
It looks like a child-friendly sort of Final Fantasy game. Although they kind of child friendly.
Now that adorable World of Final Fantasy will be released exclusively on PlayStation 4 and PlayStation Vita in 2016.
Even the logo looks a bit like King
Vita.
Many years ago.
Yeah, it was the first spot into the Vita in this trailer.
Are you really going to bother releasing it on Vita?
One of the most beloved games in PlayStation and video game history.
Oh god, here we go.
Tonight, I am proud to announce that by popular demand, we have a very special treat for everyone.
This is what I
actually think this is what I heard about today.
Yeah.
The remake.
Yeah.
Long ago, we looked upon a foreboding sky. The memory of a star that threatened all.
Yes, it looks like hearts.
It could well be.
Might as well just get our dicks out now and jack off the rest of the video game community.
Can you find a female's presence, please?
Sorry, Abbie. You just have to get over it.
Do you think it is? It's just last time I saw Final Fantasy VII, it was all very pixelated.
I preferred the pixelated.
That someday we would see them again. Perhaps it was no more than wishful thinking.
That's Barrett.
You mean Mr. T?
Mr. T.
Yeah.
Fool!
The promise has been made.
That's just ridiculously sized, so.
Yeah, but that's kind of obviously cool.
Yeah. Missed it.
Then you were getting excited. You said in the other video that you weren't a fan of this game.
Yeah, but. Because it's too old. I wouldn't mind trying the remake to see what they do.
I think it detracts from how good FF15 looks. Because that looks amazing.
I've already seen much of 15. I think that's what I was doing.
But it's another remake.
Yeah.
Yeah, but this is a remake people have actually been asking for 20 like 10 years.
It's 20 years.
It's not being remade from a PlayStation 3.
And they still forget there's a load of PlayStation 1 and 2 games that need remaking.
Yeah.
Spyro 2.
With Devolver Digital has brought us
but I don't even think they necessarily need remaking, they just need bringing onto the new consoles.
Yeah.
Because it's the old
today,
style that keeps
we're announcing four new games from Devolver that are all making their console debut on PlayStation 4.
Cool. Considering that was probably the biggest announcement Sony just had, they sort of placed over it. Oh, it's not speedrunners. It looks like speedrunners.
That looks pretty cool.
This looks like an indie game.
These are indie games, I think.
Yeah, they are. Pretty sweeping through these with the show.
I think he's going through a load of indie games at the
Jesus Christ! Mother Russia bleeds! Holy shit! Oh, it's like Double Dragon!
Oh yeah! It is a bit.
See, I guess they wouldn't be...
That was pretty cool.
Because they'd just be downloading it, they wouldn't release it on disc. Too small for most of it.
It's a hot line,
these all look the same kind of games.
Yeah, same developer. Devolver Digital, releasing for a game. It'd be good to get a contract for four.
Yeah.
Now, how our fans engage in the future of gaming continues to astound us. Devoted fans have funded some amazing games for PS4 via Kickstarter. Octodad,
Broken Two Dads and Bane. Playing that co-op is brilliant.
Now, recently, oh, hilarious.
A developer told us that they're bringing back a fan favorite Kickstarter.
The deadliest PC catch.
And PS4. Now, this is very much their project, but we wanted to celebrate their announcement on our stage, since this is a game that PlayStation fans have been very, very, very vocal about.
Okay. So Kickstarter is when they fund.
Shenmue.
Oh right.
Bloody hell! Didn't expect that. Frig, I've got to get a Dreamcast now.
This is going to sound really sad, but you can borrow mine if you want.
You've got it.
Yeah. I have Shenmue.
That's like the one game people say to try from the Dreamcast.
Yeah, Kickstarter's crowdfunding. People pledge money to it. If they get the goal, then the money gets taken out, and then they provide it to everyone who's pledged first.
It's just donations, isn't it?
Yeah. But if you don't make the goal, then no one gets charged, and you just don't get the money.
Shenmue 3 will be the story. Oh wait, I saw something about this on Twitter actually. It said Shenmue 3 hit 1 million or something in the record time for Kickstarter. Yeah.
Wow.
Shenmue
experience you have dreams
of. The fate of Shenmue. Oh, he's wearing the jacket as well.
Yeah, try to kickstart the new clock tower.
The clock tower is just perverted though, Karen, okay. It looks good.
Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming Yu Suzuki!
Motorbike. This is such a tiny little man, look! Wow.
Hello everyone!
Alright, are we ready to get started?
Okay.
No.
Okay.
Counting down, guys.
10, 14, 7. Yeah.
Sit down. Have you never played Shenmue?
No, I've never played it.
You've wandered around asking people like sailors.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Welcome, mate.
Has he literally just gone on stage to say
thank you?
Okay.
I think
you
might have voted for a Kickstarter then.
Yeah.
So it's been a pretty busy night so far, with The Last Guardian, showed that, Final Fantasy VII Remake, we're good there, yeah, Shenmue 3 Kickstarter, now there's one epic game coming next week that I'm very excited to play, let's check it out, thank you very much.
Next week? Oh, banner.
Yeah, actually, probably.
So,
one day they'll show us footage.
Like a
he's actually in game.
Actually,
yeah.
Yeah, so this is probably Batman then.
Sounds like a Bioshock.
Sounds like Bioshock.
It'll be Batman.
Have a look at this. Could only be the face of a disease.
Please tell me he's still dead though.
I hope he's dead.
It would suck if they brought him back.
I like if he's died with a smile on his face.
it looks like Harvey Dent in the films.
It's mangled.
Don't you dare wake up, you bastard.
No, he's burning. He's burning up. He's dying.
Yeah, but no.
It's not that I don't like the Joker, it's just that
he needs to die.
I'd like to see someone else be the main villain for a change.
Who is it? Is it the Scarecrow?
It's supposed to be Scarecrow. But it was supposed to be Black Mask in Origins, and it turned out to be Joker again!
Yeah. Surprise! This is how the Batman died. Cheesy ass voiceover.
Oh.
What's the bet that Batman doesn't die?
What's the bet that he sails across the sea with a giant bomb
and survives?
Don't spoil it.
Somehow survives. This is how everyone thinks he died.
Yeah.
And
then we waited. Gotham braced itself for the inevitable power struggle. But it didn't come. Crime actually fell. Deep down, I knew war was coming. There's a storm.
I was just waiting.
Someone needs to fix that light.
Yeah.
Fingers, our shoes, then you got my permission to die.
Yeah.
You get to play as a cop!
It's a bit of Skyrim here. I want to
play as Batman.
Skyrim. Cool! Coffee shop minigame! Yes!
Skyrim.
Hey, I'm sorry to interrupt your dinner, Officer Owens. There's a guy smoking over there in the corner booth. Wait here. I'll have a word.
Is that Gordon Freeman?
Gordon Freeman?
It looked like Gordon Freeman from Half-Life.
Didn't Arkham City start first person?
Weren't they third person, it was just Bruce Wayne?
I'm not sure.
Can't remember. It might have been first person actually. Oh Dick?
What?
That wasn't a half cremated joke, was it?
I thought that.
I'm really hoping.
In the words of Ron Burgundy, well.
Oh no, well, this is a scarecrow sequence.
That went up a notch.
He's inhaling scarecrow.
Yeah.
Gas.
That escalated quickly. This just went up a notch. So they could be just normal people in the shooting.
Yeah.
It's weird going from Batman trailer to "Come on, give me red."
His voice does not match him.
Morpheus
was designed for PS4.
Brr.
And because of that, developers are quickly moving from the drawing board to creating 360-degree experiences that truly.
It's an Oculus Rift style thing.
Yeah, this is PlayStation's version.
What we're beginning to see is that even the simplest gameplay concepts. And taking on a new sense of depth and acceleration.
This is what they should have been doing from the start. The Kinect was the wrong direction to take. VR was
what's a Kinect?
Yeah, but if you want to blame that, you can't blame Kinect. You've got to watch Wii for starting that off.
Check that one out. The difference is that the Wii actually made some good games.
Actually, if you want to blame anything, blame iToy. I used to have iToy, every single iToy game, and they were brilliant.
They were good, man. I loved the iToy.
For the time, they were great, but by the time Kinect was coming around, this is where they should have been looking.
So basically, the iToy did stuff that the Kinect does now.
Yeah.
Oculus Rift was made by a guy in his garage.
I'm not sure how I feel about it, because... I feel like a lot of retard.
That's the point. People play the games because they can't or don't want to do it in real life.
I feel like a right idiot.
You don't want to run around.
Because the Oculus Rift, they've announced that you will have like these little nunchucks and that will be your controller. That they'll be like this, so you can move around.
Yeah.
So that's why I'm really interested now, because that was the bit I was worried about. Because if it's just a thing on your face and the controller.
I feel really silly.
Yeah.
In your living room,
you know if someone's going to come into your room and start looking at you.
I'm just going to put a FIFA on. Hang on.
It looks good. I'm not going to lie. I've watched Marker play Oculus Rift horror games, and they do look good.
Yeah. To enhance system features quickly. Anyone could creep up on you.
We recently rebranded our music service to PlayStation Music and crafted a console exclusive partnership. With the biggest brand on the planet for streaming music, Spotify. The partnership was conceived and tailored with the gamer in mind. And because of that, with nearly 5 million downloads, The Spotify app holds the quickest launch adoption rate in PlayStation history. And this year, we also delivered on the promise of PlayStation View, one of the most ambitious services we've created since launching the network.
How much money do you think they got from Big Bang Theory?
PlayStation View is not just a streaming service, it's a complete live TV experience designed for the gamer, making it simpler and easier to find
live TV designed for the gamer.
We are currently in New York.
Gamer will be gaming. That's good. Yeah, we won't be watching TV.
I don't want to watch TV.
I don't watch TV. I play games and watch movies. TV don't interest me.
PlayStation View continues to grow and our content continues to get better.
Well, that's the worry, isn't it? The consoles are just going to turn into slightly shitty PCs.
Well, that's the kind of
Thing.
Microsoft that's going to get Windows 10 on it, Xbox.
Steambox is sort of going the opposite way. It's like a shit PC trying to become a console.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Amazon offering will launch with Showtime, Fox Soccer Plus, and a new exclusive channel from Machinima.
That's kind of cool.
And PlayStation Plus members can subscribe to these packages at discounted rates.
Is it
soccer, or is
it subscribing?
We have something very special with PSU, soccer. And we look forward to many more announcements. With a robust network comes the best place to play. And each of our recent product innovations continues to advance our vision for being that place. As you've seen tonight, we're committed to bringing the biggest titles and the best experiences.
So, as you can see by me yawning, this is the
This is the bit no one cares.
Yeah, and grab a
yay, movement in games. Don't want that.
And partnerships are key to this. And tonight, I'm proud to announce that PlayStation is partnering with Activision to bring the single biggest console franchise in video games to the number one console in the world.
Call of Duty.
It's known worldwide for its epic moments and heart-racing gameplay. It's played online by tens of millions from casual fans
to pros. I love Forza.
Every year, raises the bar yet again.
Every year, no, it doesn't. It hasn't raised the bar since friggin'
Call of Duty 2, man. That was epic.
Call of Duty 1.
Do you remember that on PC?
Incredible.
The Karrot AK, man.
Black Ops 3.
Yeah. You can't even, Black Ops 3.
They can't even get inventive with the fucking names, let alone the games.
No.
Oh, God.
Here we go.
I will be the loser that will admit I have played Call of Duty Black Ops.
Hello,
I actually
barely
enjoyed it. But it is
the same.
That's the thing. The same thing. They're not terrible games. They're exactly the freaking same. Every year. They're expansions.
With Black Ops 3, we're creating the deepest, most engaging Call of Duty ever. Across the campaign,
the first four, that's
multiplayer,
plenty.
Zombies. And we've always wanted like,
and we brought zombies in. It's like, that's the selling point of Call of Duty. Bring back the Karrot AK. Bring back World War II.
People love friggin' zombies so much in this game. It's all you hear really hear about.
Yeah, zombies.
Go get left for dead.
Oh, just get left for dead. Yeah. Dead Rising. Just get...
Yeah, but Nazi zombies.
Yeah, well,
lots of zombies in lots of games.
Because the footage here is literally the same.
How you equip yourself changes the way you play each encounter. Now we got four players getting
go back to last year's E3 and they're saying exactly the same thing.
At least the new Battlefield tried to change it up with the helicopter robber style.
And putting some thought into the campaign. But this one will just be the same campaign, same boy player, minus Kevin Spacey. That's what, Sean Spacey.
This is apparently meant to be four actual players, like playing now.
Alright.
I mean, it looks really good, stunning.
I'm so laughed if this person dies in a fucking second.
Yeah, it's too hard.
Who sent these bastards to veteran? Asshole. Mob.
Easy. Looks the same.
Why show the campaign? If you do play a Call of Duty, you don't play it for the campaign. You're the only person I know that's completed a Call of Duty campaign.
I just said that I had.
Yeah, sorry. Friggin'.
Oh shit.
He's Robert Downey Jr.
Yeah, he's the Iron Man.
Jarvis. Help.
Oh.
Let's watch Call of Duty. You don't play Call of Duty, you just move forward and occasionally shoot things.
And then die within seconds.
Yeah.
And if you do kill someone, you get a stupid perk where they throw a nade at your feet.
Yeah. I don't think you're getting this yet, folks, but we're not big fans of COD.
I don't even really dislike the series. I just don't think they change it. It changes stuff.
I'm completely
it plays it safe so much, doesn't it?
Yeah.
And literally, it's like, just churns out the same thing.
I would not play them if I had no other games in my cupboard.
That's it, yeah.
It's like,
I would always choose another game.
But if I'm looking for the next big game after I've just finished one, I'm not going to look for Call of Duty because I've played it.
No, it's the thing is, you're looking for an online FPS. I know personally, I'd go Battlefield.
Yeah,
because I think it's done better.
At the moment, I'd be more interested in Titanfall 2.
Yeah,
I was
thinking Titanfall.
Yeah.
It's very good.
I think we all like Titanfall.
I didn't expect to like Titanfall a lot.
How is it? Do you remember me saying how the new Call of Duty is basically Titanfall?
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure they get in.
See, look, right.
But it's when you're a pilot.
Yeah, you just leapt over.
All the COD fanboys used to say, oh, Halo's ridiculous because you jump 50 feet in the air. Excuse me.
I'm not sure when.
Halo is a sci-fi.
Really? Yeah, Halo's a sci-fi.
This is based on reality.
Well, Black Ops 2's gameplay running up walls and leaping around and stuff.
The thing is about Titanfall, it's great from the word go. It's not just the in-game play, it's the fact that you can join games straight from the word go. It's so easy just to get on. I feel like Titanfall 2 would be more like an expansion.
Yeah.
But because that's done in a different way, I wouldn't mind that because it's a fairly small game anyway.
Yeah.
Titanfall 2, I think of Titanfall 1 as a test sort of thing.
Yeah.
I like the second one to have like 5 different types of Titan.
Yeah.
Campaign.
A campaign, a proper one.
It's got potential.
Yeah.
And you go through the
Titans that you could like even mix and match, like customised Titans, bits from other Titans. That'd be wicked.
An arm from one, your legs from the other.
Customise the Titans would be wicked. Anyway, Sony Conference.
We got a bit sidetracked there, but it's all relevant.
It's all relevant.
It is, yeah. And to be honest, this isn't just Sony stuff, is it? Because this is going to be an Xbox as well.
Yes.
I think Sony have got exclusivity for the first DLC or something like that.
Early access, probably.
Yeah.
Do it with your glass.
Says the ex-barman.
Yeah.
I will learn that from
now we get the explosion death wee wee.
You may have been a barman, but my family are alcohol experts.
Montage.
Yeah.
And now everyone goes room.
I didn't see anything in there that really grabbed me.
Please welcome David. They've just made it a bit more futuristic.
Advanced. Plus advanced warfare. The hard working men and women
of Treyarch. And introduce to you. Have a few neon lasers and stuff on them.
We're particularly excited to be hands-on this week for the first time ever at E3. Black Ops 3 multiplayer is about delivering full guns-up combat control. It's fast, fluid, and visceral, and feels unlike any Call of Duty before.
Really?
How? How?
Really?
What did you just show us that's different?
And this is the actual campaign now. Is it?
It'll be like running on walls that make it flow more.
Yeah, because that's what Titanfall is like. No, look at the point. Look at the defensive point. It's the same.
Yeah.
Same UI almost. I know they're quite the same, aren't they? Titanfall spiralled up from Call of Duty.
Titanfall added enough in to change.
Yeah, giant freaking robot.
This is.
It's the same.
The thing is, they can do it and they can get the money for it because they have
people
the
buy it, yeah.
We've just got a bit cynical, folks.
This is very Titanfall.
As much as we've been saying Call of Duty doesn't innovate enough, this isn't really innovation. This is cut and paste.
Yeah.
Well, Titanfall's done well.
if it showed me something cool, the same with the other games where we've said, that looks wicked.
Yeah.
That looks really cool.
I mean, the graphics look alright, but...
They would do that.
Yeah.
But if I'm getting Last Guardian as well that year, I'm already going to have the graphics fix.
Yeah.
I'm looking for a shooter that will offer something different eventually. Like, yeah. It's all about your headshots, this, that.
Yeah, this doesn't matter. The guy just appear behind someone.
Check out Splatoon. Friggin' wicked.
Isn't that paintball?
Yeah.
It's sort of like paintball, yeah. That's done very well.
I like that. You slide around the corner, sort of low down.
Yeah.
Because okay, that was something that they had in the first Call of Duties. Was, you know, you could have the lean and you could lean out around the corner. Yeah. And they took it out after the second one.
Yeah.
If they were to bring that in, because I really like that feature, that'd be cool to bring back.
Maybe a sort of character swapping it could be quite cool as well. Like, you could swap from one person in this position to another person over there. From that,
you can do that
main man to sniper.
Yeah.
As I mentioned, this is the start of a new era for PlayStation and this famed franchise. I'm pleased to announce today that starting from Call of Duty Black Ops 3, PlayStation owners will be the first to play all map packs from this great series.
Now you're righteous.
Yeah, you're right, mate.
Just bring all the three maps in for free.
Because they're finished anyway. The upcoming
multiplayer beta pay for half the game after it's already been released.
PlayStation is the new home of Call of Duty, and we look forward to sharing more information with you soon. Now let me show you some more of the great titles and content coming to PlayStation. Thank you.
Come on, I'll be waiting for it. Come on, yeah.
What are you waiting for?
Uncharted 4.
I was going to say, yours is going to be Uncharted, didn't it?
Love Uncharted, man.
I like the first one.
Yes!
I can't wait for Metal Gear Solid 5.
See that piece of shrapnel is there? Makes me
Hitman, unicorn. Assassin's Creed.
These are all
unicorns.
Deus Ex looks very good as well, actually. Mankind Divided. I like the story of Deus Ex.
I think Tom Clancy's bringing Smith back as soon to...
I do need to play through all the Uncharted games. I have no idea what Tom Clancy game is,
because it could be quite a few, couldn't it?
Recently found out that God of War 3 was getting another remaster.
Yeah.
After I'd already said that I'm sick of the Uncharted remaster. It's like, come on.
Very good, Uncharted. Batman's Motley Crue. MLB The Show. You liked that one, didn't you? MLB.
Street Fighter!
Ratchet and Clank remake. Oh yeah.
This looks like it's your early, Karrot.
Yeah, he plays friggin' Bayonetta.
I haven't finished Bayonetta.
Oh, Vita!
The Vita stuff! Yay, 2 minutes!
Look, we haven't forgotten about it, look!
There it is.
It's still a thing.
Oh. Such a good bit of terror.
Look how bored they are.
I was going to say, he's not impressed, did he? He don't care.
He's just there like, got a DS.
Yeah, 3DS is so much better than the Vita, it's unbelievable.
That's something I meant to say in our predictions as well afterwards. It's been a while since a new handheld has been announced.
Well, I don't know, they just released the new 3DS in there.
Yeah, that's true, they just keep re-releasing the DS, don't they?
Until it stops making money.
Yeah.
It's so much money, isn't it?
It's because everyone buys them, old, young.
The thing with the new 3DS.